Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nevenka Lejcovic. I come from University of Belgrade, Center of Excellence for Green Technologies, Institute for Multidisciplinary Research, Belgrade, Serbia. Today, I'm going to talk to you about ultra-thin electro-deposited noble metals layers, next phase-based support for green energy production. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation to be part of this special event, Materials, the Building Block for the Future, organized by University of California, Los Angeles. I'm also sorry not to be in Los Angeles today, since I was planning that. However, I was prevented by COVID-19 disease. I would like to pay your attention that this presentation contains copyright protected materials, so please treat it confidentially. Before I start with the results, I would like to introduce you to University of Belgrade, one of the biggest and the most important universities from Southeast Europe, ranked among the best world universities by the Shanghai Jiaotang University ranking list. University of Belgrade consists of 31 faculty and 11 institutes dealing with the science of different fields from natural sciences, social sciences, and also technical sciences. One of the parts of University of Belgrade is Institute for Multidisciplinary Research, my institution, a leading research and development institution founded to combine fundamental and applied research in following research areas, material science, energy and environmental sciences, life sciences, neurosciences, and medical engineering. I work at material science department. I would like also to pay your attention on collaboration network of the Institute of Multidisciplinary Research, University of Belgrade. My institute have established many fruitful collaborations from all over the world, research and scientific institutions from all continents except Africa. Some of them are Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratories from California, University AGH from Krakow, Technical University from Zurich, and many other important scientific institutions. Let's introduce energy problem and as the main, one of the main challenges and problems of the contemporary world. At this slide, US primary energy consumption was presented by energy source. As you can see, energy consumption and production is based on fossil fuels, petroleum and natural gas. Only 11% belong to renewable energies, as you also can see. Renewable energy consisted of geothermal, solar, hydroelectric, biomass, waste, biofuels, and other renewable energy resources. As for renewable energy share, for instance, in Europe 2020, you can see that there is hydropower, geothermal electricity, wind power, biomass electricity, and many other renewable energies from bioethanol, biodiesel, and hydrogen also as from renewables as one of fuels for the future. At this stage, I would like to emphasize advantages of renewable energy sources. To use renewable energy, we will avoid environmental pollution, greenhouse effects created by carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases present in the atmosphere. So the target of Europe and USA authorities is to use renewable energy sources more than fossil fuels in the future. Let's talk about hydrogen, pure, high-efficiency, environmental-friendly fuel, usually produced by gas or oil decomposition. in nuclear plants or by biomass degradation. The pure hydrogen is produced by water electrolysis, well-established procedure, at from 30% sodium hydroxide solution at 80 degrees of centigrade, nickel-based electrodes. The hydrogen produced by water electrolysis is used for the fuel in polymer electrolyte membrane for fuel cells, while common oxidative agent is oxygen from air. So, hydrogen is considered as environmental friendly, high efficiency, zero emission energy conversion fuel for power sources. Many prospective applications of PEMST in applications in portable, stationary, and transport devices. At this slide, it is here just to explain what we are working for. So, actually, we are working on nanomaterials for green energy related applications, not only nanomaterials, also electrodepositive materials for anode or cathode catalysts. For water electrolysis and also for anode and cathode catalysts for polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cells. Hydrogen produced in electrolyzers is used as a fuel in polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cells, and then energy produced is used for cars, portable devices, and other. Objectives of today's our presentation would be a characterization of the support titanium aluminate carbide, MEX phases, one of the MEX phases, famous supports, electrochemical deposition of ultra-thin iridium layers on titanium aluminate carbide support, is chemical characterization by scanning electron microscopy, X-ray photoelectric spectroscopy, and energy dispersion spectroscopy. Hydrogen evolution reaction or iridium-based catalyst, and also comparison of catalytic obtained activities to commercial carbon-supported iridium ERC. Let's talk about characterization of substrate. Substrate is titanium aluminate carbide, one of the MEX phases, famous materials, it was patented for Professor Braston from Drexel University 2003. And these materials have excellent properties and desirable properties like high conductivity, high chemical and corrosion stability, and it is also commercially produced easily in low cost procedure, also as solid materials and in the powder form. As for electrochemistry, it is important to emphasize that titanium aluminate substrate is very stable in the wide potential range, and it is also very suitable for support for catalysts. So, we have electrodeposited iridium layers on titanium aluminate carbide, five samples from thicknesses 4.5 nanometers to 255 nanometers, and they used for investigation of hydrogen evolution in sulfuric acid solution. As you can see, we have deposited iridium from this solution by linear seed voltammetry, 5 millivolts per second, and from this peak and from the charge of the electrodeposited layer should be by integration should be obtained, and then also thickness of the deposit using these equations. At this table, it is presented mentioned five samples and conditions for them their to the position. We have used concentration of potassium iridium chloride from 1 millimole to 3 millimoles, and number of cycles from 1 to 5. And so, as you can see, deposit thickness was from 4.5 to 255 nanometers. Let's see scanning electron microscopy surface morphology analysis from this slide. You can see that sample 1 and 2 are almost completely covered and quite homogeneously covered, but for sample 3, 4, and 5, you can see that there are micro cracks due to the peeling off effects. And for us, it is important that on more thinnest sample, this one, sample 1, was completely covered even at these arrows we have analyzed by EDS. The surface, and it was found that iridium is still present at these places. X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy analysis with a proper form showed the iridium for F spectra for all samples presented at this slide and fitting results. As you can see, we have found only one doublet. It's corresponding to the iridium zero oxidation state. We have found only metallic iridium on the surface. It was one of the goals. Electrochemical impedance spectroscopy was used to determine kinetics and mechanism of the reactions. And equivalent circuit use is presented here. As you can see, very good agreement between experimental. It is by line, is presented fitting results, and agreement is between fitting and experimental results is obvious. This polarization curve for the best sample, one, the thinnest one, of thickness of 4.5 nanometers, is presented together with iridium supported commercial carbon support. And as you can see, especially at high current densities, our new catalyst is exhibiting better catalytic activities. In this table, it is summarized current density, also our potential at 10 milliamperes per square centimeter, 100 and 300, as it is usual for hydrogen evolution. In industrial application, and as you can see, the sample R has better activity, even especially pronounced at the high over potential and at the low over potential at the 300 milliamperes per square centimeter. And just to conclude, ultra-thin iridium layers were electrodeposited on titanium alumina carbon support successfully. This catalyst exhibited high catalytic activities for her in acid solution in comparison to carbon support iridium 1. The best performance was obtained for the thinnest one, 4.5 nanometer thick layer. And at last, but not at least, I'd like to thank to my dear colleagues, Dr. Vladimir Jović, Dr. Nedeljko Krstajić, Dr. Uloš Lačnevac, Mila Krstajić-Fajić, Borka Jović, Ljena Gajić-Krstajić, and Piotr Žavinski. And also, I would like to thank you for your attention and to thank Ministry of Science, Education and Technological Development, Republic of Serbia, for the financial support. Also thank Professor Miladin Radović from the Texas A&M University College Station for the preparation of titanium alumina carbide substrate.